Hi, my name is Rabbi Pini Duna. Welcome to my weekly Erev Shabbos Dvar Torah. This Shabbos, tomorrow, we're going to be reading Parshas Tetzaveh. There's a story in the Gemara in the Talmud, in Maseches Shabbos, it's a Daf Lamed Aleph Amud Aleph, about a Gentile who was walking past a shul one Shabbos. And guess what? He heard them reading the portion from the Torah that talks about how they should make the priestly garments, describing them in every detail. It was, of course, it's Parshas Tetzaveh that week, and that's what he heard. Anyway, he was so intrigued, so impressed by how amazing the clothes sounded, that he went into the shul and asked someone, "Hey, who's the guy who wears these beautiful clothes? Please tell me." So the fellow there told him that these clothes that they were reading about were worn by the Kohen Gadol, the high priest. So listen to this crazy story. The Gentile was so excited about the clothes and he really wanted to wear them. So he decided he's going to convert to Judaism so that he can become the Kohen Gadol and he should be able to wear these amazing clothes. It's a crazy story, right? So he went off to see the greatest rabbi that he could find. It was Shammai. And the Gentile comes in to see Shammai and he says to him, "I want to convert to Judaism on condition that I can become the Kohen Gadol." Now, as we all know, Shammai was not someone who suffered fools gladly, or indeed suffered them at all. And when he heard the Gentile's request, he took a massive stick and he chased him out of his house. "Get out and never come back." But it seems that the Gentile was pretty determined. Off he went, and he approached Hillel, who was the other great rabbi of that time, and he presented him with the same proposal. "I want to convert to Judaism on condition that I can become the Kohen Gadol." Hillel patiently listened to him, stroked his beard, nodded, closed his eyes, thought for a moment, and then he said to him, "Listen, my dear friend, I hear you, but if you want to become the Kohen Gadol, you really must first learn all the rules of what it means to be a Kohen. Then, once you've learned everything, come back to me and we can talk again about conversion to Judaism." So off the guy went, this Gentile, and he began to study all the laws of the sanctuary and how to be a priest. Well, guess what? Soon enough, he came to the Pasuk in Bamidbar, in chapter 3, Perek Gimel, "V'azor ha-korev yumos." Any stranger who comes anywhere near the sanctuary will be executed. I think you'll agree that this Pasuk is quite unequivocal. The Gentile was understandably a bit taken aback, and he asked around, who is this Pasuk referring to? The teacher, whoever it was, told him that this rule about non-Kohens being liable for the death penalty if they entered the sanctuary applies to everyone, including every Jew who isn't a Kohen. It even applies to David HaMelech, King David himself. Anyone who's not a Kohen cannot do the temple service. It's as simple as that, period. Suddenly, the penny dropped, and this Gentile realized he would never qualify to even be an ordinary priest, never mind a Kohen Gadol. But guess what? He converted anyway. I told you it's a crazy story. And many years later, he went to see Shammai and he told him, "If I'd only gone to you and never gone to Hillel, I would never have converted. But Baruch Hashem, I went to Hillel because he was so patient with me, he was so open to me. And because of that, I was lucky enough to convert and become a Jew." Now, interestingly enough, Shammai's response to this is not recorded in the Gemara. But in any event, you could ask why Hillel did what he did with this Gentile. Of course, we know that Hillel had a very patient temperament, and he wasn't ill-tempered like Shammai. But still, why didn't he just tell the guy straight? Nicely, of course, not chasing him out of the house with a stick. "Listen, my friend, you won't be able to become a Kohen Gadol for a very simple reason. You weren't born a Kohen." Why did he send him off to learn about priesthood? It almost seems as if he was misleading him, kind of implying that he could learn about the laws and then become a Kohen and maybe even a Kohen Gadol. not right. I'll tell you why. It's very powerful. Do you know what we can learn from this Gemara? Do you know what we can learn from what Hillel did? That a teacher must always pick the right time and make sure their student is ready to learn a particular lesson. Sometimes a teacher wants to teach something, but at that exact moment, his student is just not ready to hear what he wants to teach. The teacher can stand on his head and try anything to teach the lesson, but the student just won't understand it. And nothing will be gained. It's a waste of time. He or she is simply not in the mental state to accept that lesson at that particular moment. If Hillel would have said at that first meeting, "Listen, Mr. Gentile, I'm so sorry that there is no way you can ever become the Kohen Gadol," the Gentile would have had the same reaction to Hillel as he had to Shammai. You see, at that moment, he was not in a mental state to hear that message. So he just would have not heard it. And who knows what he might have thought he heard or what he would have done afterwards. Hillel was so wise. He sent the guy to school. He offered him the opportunity to learn the truth in a non-threatening, non-confrontational context. Hillel thought, let him sit in a Bais Medrash and learn alongside others. Let him read the posuk about what happens to non-priests who pretend to be Kohanim in the Torah and innocently find out why that, what he wanted to do, could never happen. Then, and only then, he would be able to accept it. There are so many times, particularly with our children, when we want to teach them something, whatever it is, we want them to be aware of a certain law, a certain practice, a certain custom, or even just how to behave correctly, but they're not ready for that message. And if they're not ready, it's like trying to teach a 2-year-old how to read, or like trying to teach a 6-month-old baby how to walk. They're just not developed enough. Not mentally, not physically, and the lesson won't get through. Do you know why? Because it can't get through. The Gemara is teaching us that you have to pick your moments carefully, wisely. One has to know when and where to deliver a lesson, a message, an idea, an ideal, so that it will be heard and so that it will make an impact. Hillel knew exactly how to bring this Gentile under the wings of the Divine Presence. That's the lesson of the story. And we, as teachers, as parents, as friends, must always try to aspire to Hillel's pedagogic insight and to emulate both Hillel's wisdom and, of course, his patience. May all the lessons we want to teach those close to us be learnt in the proper way, and may we have the strength and openness to accept all the lessons that others want to teach us. Wishing you Shabbat Shalom and Purim Sameach. Good Shabbos, good Purim, good Shabbos, good Purim.